Welcome back, True Believers. This is Rakdar, and today we're playing some Trauma Center Stack and Opinion. Today, Downpour. In the last episode, I went to a conference to talk about medical shit instead of helping a patient. And now, we get to see the terrible, terrible repercussions of my actions, which is apparently going to be a downpour of hate. This is like a fucking soap opera. Please excuse me for interrupting, Dr. Hoffman. I understand this is a little rude, but I have something to say.
What is it?
It's about the negligent attitude, Mr. What? Negligent? I had a medical conference to go to. Okay? That is really not a fair assessment of what I was doing. I am a paid doctor. I was doing medical research.
Doesn't matter how small or groundless suspicion might be, the patients are depending on them to take care of them. Why did you even become a doctor? Do you even know?
Oh, dude, Derek Stiles is really sad right now because this is the downpour. By the way, you may have noticed when you looked at the thing, this is not an episode with a mission in it. And you can tell because, basically, it doesn't have a little slash next to it, which is where the score would go. So since there's no place for the score, this is all storyline, and the rain will wash away his fears. Seer, did you come from the hospital? You might want to head back pretty soon. They don't want me. I don't think that's how hospitals work. I think it's your job, like, whether they want you or not, until they fire you. The driver flew to the street. But wait, they're saying there was an accident on Walnut, but Dr. Casey's out of town. And there aren't you... Dude. That's right. See, now, shit gets real. Life or death situation. I think this might be one of the first, like, cray-cray missions where shit gets totally wild, but I'm not 100% sure. Oh no, this actually is at the hospital, okay. Now it's time to redeem myself! I was right then, there's no time to lose!
Doctor!
So, where are the accident victims, Angie?
Dr. Stiles, the patient, he was suffering cardiac arrest and I couldn't resuscitate him. The other nurses are busy, but Dr. K's are gone. I can't, what am I supposed to do? The patient's gonna die!
Calm down, Angie, take me to the OR. Alright, this is it. Let's look at the charts. Time to get shit going. Patient suffered cardiac arrest as a result of a car accident, multiple lacerations of the epithelium, and problems in the abdomen. Why is it showing the heart? What's the situation? The ambulance brought him here as soon as they could. His heart isn't beating. I tried reviving him, but Angie!
What do I do? He's dead.
God damn it, you're not dying. Not on my operating table. Fuck this, we're gonna save this guy. Time to go Super Saiyan, Dr. Stiles. First, we need a pulse. We have to get a pulse.
I will save this
dude,
patient.
I've got stuff. I've got juices that you just inject in people and it brings them back to life. Oh my gosh. Laceration-ville.
Vitals are critical.
He has a pulse of 10. We need to recover his pulse. Let me explain how to use the... Oh, there's a defibrillator? Okay. First, move the paddle toward the patient. What? There we go. Alright, now I'll explain... Oh my gosh. This is ridiculous. Keep an eye on the meter displaying the level of electric charge. Activate the shock when the meter reaches the area in the gauge. The closer the reading you get... Oh my gosh. Now you need to know how to activate the defibrillator. Once it's moved toward the patient, press the... Oh my gosh. Oh, I... Crap, I fucked it up. See, that was right. I'm getting it in the gray. Dude, I'm doing really badly. There we go. That had to...
We have a pulse.
Yeah, there we go. Vitals are still below 30. He's not in the clear yet. So your Dr. Stiles, are we gonna save him? Of course we are! I've got my fucking mask on. Alright. Dude, vitals are below 30. That means we have to put in life juice and lots of it. Oh yeah, stabilize the fuck out of this guy. Alright, I think I have to use the antibiotic ointment on these. Nope, I just have to seal them up. Dude, easy peasy. Oh yeah.
Proceed as normal.
Look at, I love how my stitches are just like fucking random, and that's the way to do it. That's the way real doctors do it, is they just fucking throw those stitches right on your fucking chest.
Bleeding seemed to have stopped, but his vitals are dropping fast. He suffered a lot of damage to his chest. What else could it be?
I like how I just stitched up over this, and I'm just gonna cut through the fucking stitches. That's how fucking modern medicine works. Cut through the fucking Oh, I need to... Antibiotic ointment. There we go. Cool. Oh, dude, I'm doing... I don't wanna jinx myself. Oh my gosh!
Impossible.
There's fucking glass chunks. There's a... Okay, dude, we can do this! I'm just gonna take all the glass out of his heart. Either way, I don't blame you. This is your decision, dude. We don't need Dr. Kazel.
You have to be careful.
Yeah.
I believe in you.
Oh my gosh. You hear that? She believes in me. She's never said she believes in me before. And I'm like, what? I like how missing the tray is a miss, and he's gonna die if I don't antibiotic ointment these. There we go. Oh, yeah. Oh, that was close. That was a very near-death experience. I've always thought it was funny that if you miss the tray with the glass, that is... Oh! Okay. Oh, whoops. I fucked it up. Oh my gosh. Dude. There we go. I was like, the defibrillator is not superbly easy to work. We have a pulse. Wait! What? How could there was just glass inside the thing, and it just, like, poured out of him. Oh! Wait. That is... I have to do this now. See, I hate that so much that if you miss the tray, it pulls that shit on you. Look at this. Tell me I did not drop that shit right on the tray the other two times. I am pretty sure I dropped it right on the tray. Can you just sew people's hearts up?
What?
No. No.
Wait.
What?
Don't die on me.
Oh.
I won't let him die.
What just happened? Oh, I know what just happened. I just slowed down time. All right.
What just happened?
You suffered. I think we finished. This is fucking crazy. This is not how medicine works. All right, whatever. Wait, I'm still on stitches. Oh yeah. Wait, that was cool. That was not good. You fucking lying sack of shit. That was not good. That was cool and you know it. They are not giving me the respect I deserve. That was cool, at least. Okay. Dude, one thing I'm always cool at is putting the bandages on. Look at that, and I earned her faith back. Now she finally loves me again. My life is meaningful. I had to have gotten a B. Oh, come the fuck on. Did you see all the cool little cools I got during that? It's because I missed the tray when I was putting the fucking glass on. That's why I got a C, not a B. And I didn't miss the tray. See, fuck that shit. I like how if you, like, drop the glass on the side, it just sucks right back into the fucking wound. Bullshit.
Yes?
Everything you said this morning was true. But I'm gonna stay here as a doctor. I'm gonna try harder. I'll become a better surgeon and make you proud.
If that's the case, stop coming into work late and don't leave without your paperwork.
I'll do my best.
And there's one other thing,
huh?
Please, try to be more presentable. I shouldn't have to worry about being embarrassed to work with you.
I'll be more careful.
Okay, I'm taking a nap. Wake me up if anything changes. Have a good rest, Dr. Stiles.
She called me a doctor. We truly have a rapport. And friendship that you would not under... Wait, what just happened? Oh, optional missions. I forgot that this is happening at the same time. All right, from overseas, let's do it. I'm going to be a different doctor now. Overseas in Santa Balboa, St. Francis Hospital. Where it's apparently a church with a lot of fine china. The patient, Alan Chambers, is suffering from... comminuted fractures in his right forearm. He was rushed here as soon as the injury occurred. Thanks to the nurses who witnessed it. Judging by the x-ray, this one could give us some trouble. But I'm sure Dr. Weave will be able to fix him up good as new.
I appreciate the confidence, but you know this is no big deal. I haven't let a patient down yet, have I?
Nozomi Weaver, age 29, a Japanese surgeon who came to America on an exchange program. Since transferring from original hospital in Okinawa, she's gained quite a reputation. Alan Chambers, isn't he a famous screenwriter? I think that's the same guy. It could certainly explain the media circus gathering outside. Maybe they'll want to interview us. Or Dr. Weaver, anyway. She's probably the most photogenic doctor here. I like how that is what's important to these guys right now. She's about to do fucking major surgery, and they're like, ah, Dr. Weaver's so hot. I'm gonna go masturbate. I'm surprised your hospital was willing to let you go, Doctor. You give me too much credit. I haven't even been here for a full year. All right, let's do it. I don't even care. Let's fix this guy's arm. I know I'm beautiful. I'm a gorgeous doctor with great rack, but I just want to fix this guy's arm, okay? Let's look at the charts. Comminuted, is that how that word is? Fracture in the patient's radius bone. There also seem to be internal hemorrhaging. Treat bleeding, then rebuild the broken bone. I'm playing this game as a backup job. I want to learn to be a doctor from this game, and then I can go, like, practice medicine. I'm sure it'll work out. I anticipate a smooth procedure. Dude, she's like holds a fake gun in her hand. She like holds a handgun to show how things are going. All right. The patient's life is in your hands. Dude, I like how it's the patient's life is in your hands, but realistically, it's just his arm. Like, I could probably...
Good.
Oh, I like how that was not cool. Like, I was like shaking and shit. Oh! Hemorrhaging looks pretty bad. I need to drain this area. All right, drain. I'm basically like
careful now.
Putting a puzzle together. Is that? Oh no, I need to drain something again. Fuck. Okay.
Next, leave it to me.
Great. Now I'll need to collect the fragments. Oh my gosh. Wait. Okay. I thought that I was gonna like be puzzling it back together myself, but apparently I'm not a good enough doctor for that. They're gonna send that to, like, the bone puzzle department, who just puts...
Wait a minute.
It looks like the ulna's twisted in the wrong direction! Alright. There we go. Oh, dude, now it might take to rotate these pieces. Oh, what? Okay.
Oh, that's not right!
Oh, no, wait. Yeah, I get it. Great. What is... Alright. How do I... Oh, I actually rotate the controller. This is the Nintendo, in case you're wondering
I see.
What console this is the Nintendo Wii. It's got a rotatable controller. Where does this one go? Fuck. Just drop the bone in his arm. Wait, okay, maybe it doesn't go there. Maybe it goes here. Oh, okay. Oh my gosh. I'm good at puzzles. It's like, oh, my hand is shaking so much. I'm not gonna lie, guys. I've never performed actual surgery before. Wait! Something isn't right. There's a piece missing! Uh-oh. Probably still a fragment I haven't found yet. Alright, ultrasound. Dude. Alright. Oh, it's just like... Why couldn't I just see that before? Oh. Oh, I have to... Okay, so it has to be ultrasound. Wait. Oh, wrong. There we go. And... Now I don't need to give it to the puzzle piece sorting department. I can just put it in myself. Why couldn't I do that before? Seriously. Wait, I should apply some antibiotic gel to make sure the area is healing properly. Oh, yeah.
Done.
Bones. The radius bone has been reformed. I entered a quick recovery. Alright, wait, okay, I was like, what do I do now? Oh, it's not being clear. Dude, this was a super... Oh, what? And so his arm. That was bad, but it was not bad because I sewed his arm to the bed. It was bad because I didn't get it on the first try. Like, I'm dead serious. But the misses is like because it wasn't like holding my shit right. I swear. Like, what happened there was it wasn't holding down the A button. I should have gotten an A on that operation because it was easy. Another amazing operation, Dr. Weaver. I think we all learned a thing or two. Well then, if you'll excuse me. See you tomorrow. So, Dr. Weaver, I like how even the light in the hospital, in the like Catholic hospital, is in the shape of a cross. But everyone here is so kind; they accepted me as one of their own immediately. I always like Japanese like stereotypes about Americans are always pretty funny. All right, I am going to end this episode right here. In the next episode. I'm gonna find out about my dormant ability.